cardio in the off season or in the improvement season? My apologies.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm still doing cardio. Right now we're at 90 minutes a week. So I do 3 days, 30 minutes. Nothing crazy. Mm-hmm. We did have it down to just once a week, 30 minutes, but we decided to add those other 2 days to kind of help me put food in faster.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Staying a little more active.
Yeah, I mean, nutrition is such a huge part of that, you know, that improvement season process. I do think mm-hmm. that, like, to your point about some people considering an off season, I think that even happens in the industry itself. But like some people, and I've noticed it in the men. I don't know how it is like with the girls. You probably know better than I would, but some people just take it way too far. Like their improvement season, they're just taking so many calories and they're taking and just completely just eating whatever that they gain so much body fat. And then when you're trying to cut, you're just doing all this unnecessary work.
It'll take a while.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it'll take a while to get there if you, you know, added so much.
Right. For sure. Do you have a particular like weight that do you monitor your weight at all?
We don't. So I've been 138, pretty steady. I don't know if we have like a certain weight that we're trying to hit or anything like that. The last, improvement season, I got up to 149. So I was close to 150. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if I'll hit that this time. I don't know.
So it's nothing. Yeah. It's nothing that you guys are like necessarily focused on. It's just,
no.
Yeah. Sometimes people get tricked by like the scale too, right? Like,
right.
You'll be heavier and you'll think, oh, well, I must be adding like more muscle. Right. But that's not necessary. Right. It's not necessarily the case.
It'd be nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. It'd be nice.
Oh man. So, you said you're doing your improvement for the year and then you're going to look in the shows, after that. Is there anything in particular that sticks out in your mind? Like I want to do this particular show. Have you thought about it at all?
I don't know. I think the way my coach says, he's like, you know, let your body pick your show date. So that's really, I guess, drilled into my head where it's like, we're just going to go with it. And whenever we think we'll be ready, then we'll look at shows and see.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that definitely makes sense. It's like, once you're kind of in the, you know, condition you need to be in, you can just, you know, go from there. Are you the type of person that like to hit several shows at once, like once you're in condition, or are you just focused on like one show and then you'll go, you know, into another improvement period?
I don't know. That's a good question. So after I won the overall in November, I didn't want to do more shows. One, because you know, that was the end of the year.
Right.
But my purpose with that show was to see, what do I look like? What do I need to work on for the national level? So I think next time around, I'll have to do, you know, another regional show to requalify probably. And then from then, hopefully, you know, that's always the goal, is to be competitive. So if we are competitive, then, you know, go to a national show and try to go pro. But I don't really, I guess I don't really decide. I don't really think of like, oh, I want to do X amount of shows. I just think like strategically,
right?
Where am I at? You know?
Yeah. Because the ultimate goal for you is just to get that pro card, right? Like, so you want to, you want to try to kind of channel your focus into what gets you there fastest.
Yeah. And I think, you know, someone who goes to a national show and let's say they're not as conditioned, and so that's why they didn't win. That would make sense to then do another show later. But if the issue is you don't have enough size, I don't see why do another show. You know, I would go, okay, let's build, because now we're wasting time instead of building.
Right. Because size, like, you know, if it's an issue of like conditioning and peaking and things like that, that can be changed in a week to week basis, then, you know, you can solve that and go ahead and step on again. But if, like you said, if it's size, that's going to take, you know, maybe another year for that too, depending on how much size you're trying to put on.
Yeah. And I mean, you know, when you go to shows, it's all depending on who's there. Right. So, and the way I see it, it's like, I don't want a pro card. I want to look like a pro. So if I don't look like a pro and I win, that's not meeting my goal, you know?
Yeah. So. Well, you also want to hit the ground running, right? Probably as a pro, mm-hmm. I would imagine. So sometimes what you'll have is you'll have people. There was a guy at my gym here in Nashville, Tennessee, a few years back, and he won his pro card, but he just wasn't like, he won it in a situation where in an, you know, if it was another lineup or something else, like he mm-hmm. probably would not have won it, but right. because of that, he didn't really do much damage in the pro ranks at all, because it's just, he didn't look like a pro. He happened mm-hmm. to get the card, but it was a fluke situation. So yeah, I mean, I get your point of view, because I mean, you don't want to win and then just sit out trying to improve. You want to already be there.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And that's why I say, you know, like as an amateur, I'm not in a hurry, you know, because that's so true. You know, if you turn pro but don't look like one, well, now you got to take all this time off to grow. Mm-hmm. So why not just do it in the beginning so that when you get there, you look like a pro and now you can, you know, potentially do well as a pro as well.
Right.